is fly season, and they are in full effect this year. We have had an incredible amount of rain, and that makes conditions favorable for fly reproduction. So I'm not going to tell you that I don't have any flies, because that would be a lie, but I'm going to tell you the things that I do to keep them under control. One of the big things is just management around the farm. So when the horses are in, which is just during bad weather, I try to keep the stalls really clean, at least once a day, usually twice a day. I also keep the paddocks picked up, so the roughs, the area where manure accumulates, I keep that picked up. And then I take that manure and I spread it out in the farm field that's next to us, and I spread it really thin so that it dries out really well. And that way then the flies can't reproduce in it. And once the crops get a little bit bigger, I'll be taking that manure and putting it on flower beds and in the garden. And then eventually I will be piling it up, which I imagine that is probably what most people do with their manure. Ideally, if you pile manure, if you have a tractor with a loader and you can turn that pile every few days, that will help keep fly reproduction at a minimum, because the inside of a manure pile gets really hot and the flies can't reproduce in it. They can only reproduce in the perimeter. So by mixing it every few days, you cook those fly eggs that were on the outside that then you get turned into the inside. The other thing I do with with pasture management is that when I move horses off of a pasture because they've grazed it down and I move them to the next pasture, I go to that old pasture and I drag the manure piles again to break up the roughs. So with this hot summer weather, that really cooks and dries out the manure, and that eliminates some breeding grounds for the flies. The other thing that I do is the fly predators from Spalding. I don't know if you're familiar with these, but these arrive every 3 or 4 weeks during fly season. They come in this bag. It's clear on the back. When you see the eggs starting to hatch and little bugs in there, you release it in the areas where flies reproduce. So around your manure piles and the roughs and any decaying organic matter. The Spalding fly predators are a little bit more expensive than the other brands, but I have really found that they work a lot better. And they also have three types of bugs there that help to predatorize the fly eggs. And so that way you get ahead of flies, because those bugs parasitize the flies before they can develop. Moving on to fly traps, we got a couple different fly traps, and I am going to link those for you. And I got 8 packs of both of these, and trust me, you are going to want the 8 packs, because it is the beginning of July and I'm already going to reorder on these fly traps. So this one works really well. It smells like a bag of death, okay? But what you do is you just cut a hole on the top on the dotted line, you pull that plastic part out through the top, and then tie a string on it. Don't just thread the string through there. Tie a knot and tie it on there. Then you fill it with water to the line and you hang it away from your barn, okay? Because this lures flies in by scent. So you don't want to be attracting them into your barn, and you don't really want to be smelling this. So hang it away from your barn and it will draw the flies away. And you have a bag of black, nasty, dead flies. And it's great. When it's time to throw those away, either when it's full, it dries out, or after a month, they say, you just throw it away. So easy disposal on that is to take like a plastic shopping bag and hold it up underneath that, cut the string that you put on there, close the lid on it, tie it up, and throw it away. But do it on trash day, because you don't want that hanging around your house. It's nasty. These fly traps are sticky fly traps, and these worked amazingly well in the right location. They don't do well outside. They don't hold up well to weather, but they do really good in the barn. And they attract flies visually with this pattern, so they're not drawing in any flies that aren't already there. These are covered in flies in black in a week in my barn. I have an older guy that he still gets hay because he likes to chew on it, so he mushes it up and drops it, and that attracts the flies. Even though I clean it up 2 or 3 times a day, it attracts the flies, so I hung them above where he is, and I catch a lot of flies with this. Keep in mind, small birds can get attached to these sticky traps, so you want to place them in locations where you feel like it's going to minimize that. I would love to have these everywhere, but we are a bird-friendly barn, so I don't have as many of these out as I would like, but this is my last one out of 8, and I also had picked one up originally at Tractor Supply, but the best price was on Amazon in an 8-pack, so I will link that. As I was saying, we are a bird-friendly barn, and birds help to really control the flies and the mosquito problems. We have barn swallows in our barn, and they will eat up to 250 bugs a day. And if you just keep your like doors open, like top doors on your Dutch doors, or if you have big doors, and if you have anywhere in your rafters where you can put like maybe a little board or somewhere where they can start their little mud nest, they are super helpful with controlling bugs. And then we also have purple martins, which are a little bit more particular, a little harder to get. You can look up stuff on the internet for those. They have special purple martin houses, and they eat up to 1,000 bugs a day. So definitely look into that. I also use fly wraps, and I have a video I've already done on that. I will link that so you can check out why I use fly wraps. I'm going to give you some tips. I also review some of the top brands and give you my picks. So take a look at that one. And that's the main things that I do for fly control in my barn. I try to keep things as natural as possible. As far as fly spray goes, I stay away from the pyrethrin fly sprays. I've been trying out a lot of natural fly sprays here recently. I haven't found anything that I'm super thrilled with that I want to tell you guys about yet. But if you have a fly spray that is a natural fly spray that you love, please let me know in the comments, along with anything else that you do for fly control that works really well for you, because we all have to work together to wage war on these flies. I'm Deanna Price. This is my channel, Shade Tree Stables. And if you want to do me a favor, you could hit the subscribe button. And I want to thank you for watching.